It seems like every couple of weeks, the news headlines announce a new Earth-sized planet, making it look as if leaving Earth and inhabiting another planet is just around the corner. But actually, we are far from that. In this video, we're going to talk about a planetary system that made the world go crazy back when it first came out with how many Earth-sized planets it contains. We are talking about the planetary system TRAPPIST-1. The story goes back to the year 1999 and begins with a star 40 light years away in the constellation Aquarius. The star was discovered by the astronomer John Geisses with the help of his colleagues. They gave the star the hideous long name 2MASJ23062928-052285. The star was identified as an ultra-cool M-type dwarf star. That's a type of star which, as their name suggests, holds a very low temperature that goes below 2700 Kelvin, 4400 degrees Fahrenheit. You might think that that's still very hot, but believe me, for a star that's ultra cool, much cooler than our sun's surface temperature, for example, that goes to nearly 6000 Kelvin, or 10,000 degrees Fahrenheit. The star is very dim in the night sky. Stargazers cannot see it with the naked eye, and in comparison to our sun, the star 2MASJ23062928-052285 is a dwarf star with only 11% of the sun's diameter, which makes it just a little bit bigger than Jupiter. And it's also much redder in color than the sun. And because of its small size, the star consumes fuel much slower than our own sun. That's why when we look at its age, we find it twice as old as the sun. Scientists have estimated the star's age to range between 5.4 and 9.8 billion years, while our sun is only 4.5 billion years old. The story progresses till we reach the year 2008, when the construction to build a new telescope called TRAPPIST was approved. The name is short for Transiting Planets and Planetesimals Small Telescope, and it's a telescope funded by the Belgian Fund for Scientific Research and Liège University in Belgium. The TRAPPIST telescope consists of two robotic telescopes, one located in the La Silla Observatory in Chile and the other in the Ouke Imeden Observatory in Morocco. The main purpose of building this telescope was to study bodies outside the solar system, such as exoplanets and comets and asteroids and other small bodies. Now we fast forward again to the year 2016 when astronomer Michael Gillian alongside NASA astronomer Susan M. Lederer found three Earth-sized exoplanets around the star 2MASJ23062928-052285. And in honor of the TRAPPIST telescope, astronomers gave the star a newer, neat, and fancy name, TRAPPIST-1. More observations in the following year using the NASA Spitzer Space Telescope and other telescopes have discovered that the star TRAPPIST-1 actually hosts seven Earth-sized exoplanets, not just three. And all seven planets orbit the host star at a distance closer than Mercury is to our own sun. That's so ridiculously close that if you were to stand on one planet, you'd be able to see the others as moons in the sky and even visually bigger than our moon. Another thing astronomers noticed was how the planets may be tidally locked to their host star, just like how the moon is tidally locked to the Earth. Being tidally locked means that a body orbits its host with only one face always facing the host. In the case of the planetary system TRAPPIST-1, all the planets in the system may have one face facing the star at all times, leading to permanent daytime on one side and permanent nighttime on another side, which in turn causes extreme temperature change and weather patterns. The discovery marked the first time ever for astronomers to spot that many Earth-sized exoplanets around a single star. Further observations and simulations have confirmed that the first six of the exoplanets may be rocky ones, and the last planet could be of icy nature. The discovery also marked for the first time three planets, TRAPPIST-1e, TRAPPIST-1f, and TRAPPIST-1g in the same planetary system within the habitable zone. See, finding an Earth-sized planet is not merely enough for it to be able to host life as we know it. The planet needs to fall within what astronomers call the habitable zone, and also clear some criteria about its atmosphere. The habitable zone is the zone that is not so far away nor so near to a star, and at which a planet could orbit with just the right temperature for life to evolve and for water to exist on it. For example, the habitable zone of our solar system covers only planet Earth, where liquid water is found, and everywhere else in the solar system there are either water vapor or ice. Even though chances are higher within the habitable zone, scientists think it is also possible for liquid water to exist on all six of the first planets because the temperature of the host star, remember, ultra cool, is not as hot as the sun to vaporize water on nearby planets. Now, do scientists know anything about these planets' composition or size or how they look like? Well, they have a vague idea. We said earlier that the first six planets might be rocky and the last one might be icy. Now we're going to discuss the scientific data of each of the seven planets, and what astronomers know so far regarding their similarities to Earth. We begin with TRAPPIST-1b, the super-Earth-type planet with a radius that equals 1.086 times the radius of the Earth, and a mass that equals 0.85 times the mass of the Earth. It is also the closest planet to its host star, with orbital periods that equal 1.5 Earth days. Scientists also believe TRAPPIST-1b might have a thick atmosphere. The second planet in order is TRAPPIST-1c, and it is also a super-Earth-type planet, with a radius that equals 0.156 times the radius of the Earth, and a mass that equals 1.38 times the mass of the Earth. It has an orbital period that equals 2.4 Earth days, and scientists believe it has a lighter atmosphere than TRAPPIST-1b. TRAPPIST-1d is the third planet in order and is a terrestrial-type planet, with a radius that equals 0.41 times the radius of the Earth, and a mass that equals 0.41 times the mass of the Earth. It has an orbital period equal to 4 Earth days. Scientists think TRAPPIST-1d might be the lightest one among all seven planets, with only 30% of Earth's mass. TRAPPIST-1d gets roughly the same illumination from its host star as the Earth gets from the Sun. Regarding its atmosphere, though, scientists do not yet know its nature, whether it's a large atmosphere or an ocean-like, or with a thin layer covering it. TRAPPIST-1e is the first of the planets in the habitable zone, and is also a terrestrial-type planet with a radius that equals 0.918 times the radius of the Earth, and a mass that equals 0.62 times the mass of the Earth. It has an orbital period equal to 6.1 Earth days. Scientists think TRAPPIST-1e is just slightly denser than planet Earth, which means it may have a denser iron core as well. In fact, denser than any of the planets in the whole of TRAPPIST-1 planetary system, not just Earth. Scientists also suggest that TRAPPIST-1e has a light atmosphere just like TRAPPIST-1c, and that it is the most similar planet to Earth in terms of size and density and the amount of radiation it gets from its host star. But it does get a little bit less illumination from its host star than Earth. TRAPPIST-1f is the second planet in the habitable zone and is a super-Earth-type planet with a radius that equals to 1.045 times the radius of the Earth and a mass equal to 0.68 times the mass of Earth. It has an orbital period that equals to 9.2 Earth days. TRAPPIST-1g is the third and final planet in the habitable zone of the TRAPPIST-1 planetary system. It's a super-Earth-type planet with a radius that equals to 1.127 times the radius of the Earth and a mass that equals to 1.34 times the mass of the Earth. It has an orbital period that equals to 12.4 Earth days. TRAPPIST-1h is the final and farthest planet around its host star, and it is a terrestrial-type planet with a radius that equals to 0.752 times the radius of the Earth, and a mass that equals to 0.331 times the mass of the Earth. It has an orbital period that equals to 18.8 Earth days. Did you notice how the farthest planet in the TRAPPIST-1 planetary system orbits its host star much faster than Mercury orbits the Sun? Mercury takes about 88 days to orbit the Sun, while TRAPPIST-1h takes about 19 days. That gives you an idea of how small and compact the exoplanets in the TRAPPIST-1 planetary system are. Regarding the surface nature of the farthest three, TRAPPIST-1f, TRAPPIST-1g, and TRAPPIST-1h, scientists believe they're far enough from the host star that they might have frozen water on their surfaces. Scientists are able to paint these looks of TRAPPIST-1 exoplanets thanks to what is called the transit method, which is one of multiple methods used to detect exoplanets. In the transit method, astronomers look for planets that come in front of transit their host star. And when that happens, astronomers notice a dim in the star's light, announcing the existence of a planet or more orbiting around it. Further analysis done on the data from this method results in obtaining the radius and the mass of the planets, which then scientists use to calculate the density pretty straightforward, and then they can determine other important factors in the planet's looks. We should also not forget the effort of visualization scientists. Those are the people who combine science and art for the public to be able to see an artist's conception of what a world 40 light years away and more could look like. Visualization scientists transform data and numbers into art and graphics that not only benefit the public, but also paint a picture for the scientists to be able to imagine what their data means. You can enjoy the 3D artist's conception of the TRAPPIST-1 planetary system and other systems and exoplanets through the web and app version of the program Eyes on Exoplanets, made available for free by NASA. The program illustrates how it looks like to observe exoplanets up close as if you're right in front of them. So after all these observations and analysis going back more than 20 years, can we consider TRAPPIST-1 planets as our main destination for Earth 2.0? Well, not quite yet, because more information is needed regarding the planet's atmospheres, and new telescopes in the future will aid in obtaining this information. For example, now astronomers are waiting for the James Webb Space Telescope, which is planned to launch in March 2021, if it didn't get delayed because of the coronavirus pandemic. The telescope is a cooperation between the American Space Agency, NASA, and the European Space Agency, ESA, and the Canadian Space Agency, CSA. The James Webb Space Telescope is designed to look for faint infrared radiation from faraway objects like exoplanets and stars, which is exactly the kind of radiation astronomers are looking for when studying the TRAPPIST-1 planetary system. The James Webb Space Telescope will be able to provide more precise observations of faint planetary systems like TRAPPIST-1, which in turn will aid in knowing whether or not TRAPPIST-1 exoplanets have atmospheres and their compositions, if they exist. When looking into information on the atmosphere of planets in the TRAPPIST-1 planetary system, astronomers are looking for the same chemical compositions that support life here on Earth, like methane and oxygen and water vapor as well. We will definitely stay tuned for astronomers to find them.